Inline enrollment is one of several methods with which a multi-factor authentication method can be provided to a user and access be granted. If we look at it from the perspective of comparing and contrasting with the current largely automated process for enrollment, we see that that process relies, at least for the final step, on the user to read and follow the instructions in an email. Inline enrollment, by contrast, will enroll the user as the user is requesting a resource. So the user in that case is more, let's say, motivated to take action and complete the enrollment than when the email process is used. So the current process, let's call it legacy. We're using the LLEP sync agent to create the user identity in SafeNet Trusted Access based on one or more rules set up by the operator. The user will receive an email message asking the user to take action and enroll with a multi-factor authentication method. And again, most users, they will do this, and it's very powerful in that sense, but some users will not. So inline enrollment, in our first example, the user has a known Active Directory password, meaning the password is synchronized with SafeNet Trusted Access. So again, the sync agent will create the identity, in this case also synchronizing the Active Directory password. The big difference here is step number two. When the user, in the daily life of that user, tries to access some productivity resource, SafeNet Trusted Access will determine that the user must enroll the multi-factor authentication method. And so, following a few simple steps, providing the Active Directory password, the user can enroll. The second scenario, in this case, the user identity is created, but without a known Active Directory password, so it's not synchronized. Same scenario, as we access the resource, the enrollment flow will trigger, but for verification, instead of LDAP password, the user will receive an email message with a verification code. Following the validation of that code, the user will be allowed to enroll the multi-factor authentication method. In both cases, we're referring to MobilePASS Plus. Let's see the configuration in the SafeNet Trusted Access tenant. So we're looking at settings, self-provisioning, and we see for which platform this feature can be enabled. We see also that currently it's not enabled for any user, so we're going to enable it. Having a look at target platforms, we want to make sure that, well, whatever we have within the organization that's enabled or according to your policies, we probably, for usability's sake, we want to enable push-based authentication as well. I always do that. All right, so let's edit the settings here and allow all users to use inline enrollment. And then specific behavior for Windows 10, meaning how will the MobilePASS Plus application for Windows 10 be made available. So you could use a deployment tool, you could allow it to come from the Windows Store and so on. Let's see how this works. So my first example, we have a user called Sue, and she's an Active Directory user. Her password is being synchronized to SafeNet Trusted Access. Sue is now accessing some protected resource. In my case, it's just a user portal. Inputting Windows domain credentials, and oh, we've got to protect the account, right? And there's a lot of information here for the end user, you know, written in sort of a colloquial language. We get a choice here because of the policy I said. We get the choice of Windows or mobile device. I'm going to enroll this on Windows 10 desktop. Additional information if we care to read it. And here we could have had published a link to the Windows Store. In my case, I just set the policy that, you know, it will be available locally. We assume it's taken care of. So we see the Windows 10 MobilePASS Plus app launching. Additional very user-friendly information. You don't have to read it, but you know, if you're cautious, you could. Information about one-time passwords, one-time passcodes, we call it here. Why that's a good thing, why you should use it, and how this process will look. Information about push authentication. So just on your mobile device, there will be a notification on the Windows desktop. Enrollment starting. And I'm being asked to select a PIN code, and this is based on policy. I've got just a trivial 4-digit PIN. And we're good at this point. I'm going to close the Windows app. So again, this is a Windows app. I'm not putting a mobile mirrored app there. Now, if you have a look now in the lower right portion of the screen, you actually see the notification there. So I'm going a bit slow. Click on that. It's going to automatically launch the Windows MobilePASS Plus application. I've blurred some information here. It will prompt for user PIN. Input that, click OK. And that was successfully sent transparent to the user. I'm in the user portal now, so access has been granted. Just doing a few additional steps here, making some productivity apps my favorite applications so that they're available on my home screen next time I do this. Okay, we're good with that. Now we could just launch the app, so we could have also gone directly to, for example, AWS, and it would have been the same thing. My second example, in this case, we're not synchronizing the password. I'm also using iPhone just to show the experience on a mobile device. So we try to access some resource. Again, in this case, I'm using the user portal, which is kind of a launch pad. And I don't have a Windows password, so instead it's going to email me a verification code to my predefined email address. So on my mobile device, I'm opening, in my case, Outlook. There's already an email there, and we'll look at it. You know, see clearly visible the verification codes, 123515. Input that. And again, selection here, mobile device or Windows desktop. We've done the desktop, so let's do mobile now. Additional information, if we're again cautious or we just want to know what's going on here. Okay. And I'm going to digress a little bit. So that was in English, right? But we also localize this for most markets or wherever there is interest. So in Swedish, I'm happy to be Swedish myself, so we can do that. Okay, back to English. Just wanted to show you that. And that will be based on browser settings, so you don't have to manually set it. Okay. Press on a QR code here, and I'm going to bring up my camera app. Don't need any special app for this nowadays. And that will launch the MobilePASS app, or it will bring you to App Store to install the app if not already installed. Again, we've added some very user-friendly instructions or informational screen here to improve overall usability and user experience, user acceptance. Policy-based, I select a PIN code, very secure, 1234, repeat that. Based on policy, it will allow me to substitute that numerical PIN with biometric fingerprint. I'm going to do that. And I have enrolled this. Now we need to verify the enrollment. Testing that, so I get a notification. Tap the notification. Again, I've blurred some information here, but this is the push request. I approve it. I provide my fingerprint, so that's my thumbprint there. And authentication happens seamlessly, sort of behind the scenes. And we're in the user portal. I'll do the same thing here. I'm going to make some apps my favorite apps. But we are now successfully enrolled with MobilePASS on iOS and MobilePASS on Windows 10 for two different users. One with a synchronized password and the other one with just a synchronized identity, but no synchronized password. So yeah, inline enrollment is a feature that you can use as a substitute for the automated flow. And this will capture the user while the user is motivated to take action and will then enroll the token as opposed to enrolling using email.